What's good with you guys, man? It's been a long ass time since I've been on a camera. Since then, I've done a lot to my car. I've got a new camera, a new mic for it and everything. I'll show you guys the setup in a second. Just a heads up too, if it's a little, you know, shaky, it's cause I literally just got done working out, so my arm's still kinda, you know, tense, pump, whatever you wanna call it. But yeah, before we get into listing all the mods and showing you guys everything, I gotta hit the wash, man. Cause living in Michigan, bro, this is a huge problem. Like, look at this. God, Michigan, I like it here, but the winter, if you like having a clean car, it's horrible. Literally, like, oh my God. Yeah, I'm also still learning the angles and everything, you know, getting the right stuff done. But I'm gonna show you guys the camera setup now. We'll come over here. You should be able to see it through the tent. You can kind of see, it's kind of hard to see it. Maybe if I, no, you can see it better. But I have a DSLR camera, shotgun mic. Still got the little Gorilla tripod. Definitely a good camera. You know, I'm liking it so far. It's really sweet. This is going to be, I've done like two little test videos or whatever editing with it. It also has 4K, so a little cinematic and stuff like that will definitely be pretty good. But enough of that talking. I'm about to start this baby up, and then we're going to head to the wash, and then we'll get right into the video. You know me, man. We got to get a cold start end of the video.
Cannot apologize. Go. Welcome and upload heavy vibes. Hey, little bitch, I ain't wanna fuck until she knew that I was me. Church on Saturday about the clarity, you gon' die about the VV. Pussy play, you gon' get fucked with sucker free, so ain't she sweet. Don't put no K behind that C1 to the face, you DCG.
Alright, you guys, and one more thing. I'm just in my car parked outside the crib because I'm about to leave, but one more thing is that my videos are gonna be getting a lot better. I had an idea for this. To where I have a GoPro. I was gonna have the little head mount thing to, you know, get the views and stuff of me doing a car wash and everything, but my dumb ass lost the charger for it, so I, you know, gotta hopefully find it within the next 2 days, or I'm just gonna have to buy a new one off Amazon. But yeah, plus, you know, with the new camera, 4K, everything, you know, the video is gonna be a lot better. And, you know, it's something I've had to do for a while, but I never did it, but I'm finally doing it. Also, you know, B-rolls, all that stuff, cinematography, you know, all that stuff, just to make my videos pop way more. Just want to let you guys know that, so if you're new, subscribe, you know, put the bell on, because, you know, I'm going to try to post a video every week. I'm a busy person, you know, working, doing lots of other things. I'm going to try to at least upload once a week. That doesn't mean I can't or I won't upload more than once a week, but that's what I'm going to aim for. But yeah, let's get to this car wash. All right, you guys, we're literally about to pull up to the car wash. It ain't looking too bad. Let me bust this left right quick. And then when we get up close, we'll be able to tell. I'm probably gonna do the hand wash, just cause it's really not that bad out. It's almost 30 degrees. Yeah, the spot ain't too bad. It's a couple of open spots. Oh, I see one right there. Oh, one of them's closed though. The other one's got some on. Yeah, they got that one closed. I was about to pull in there, but I guess they got it closed. So, and Shorty's sitting in front of that one. Is it people in this one? Yup. Looks like we just gonna have to wait for one of these to get open. So, yeah. Just like that, the car over here left. So, we in business. Ooh, look at all that mush. Ooh, shit. All right, let me make sure I don't hit none while I'm trying to commandeer this camera. We'll give y'all a quick little rev in here. Something. I'm about to wash this thing, probably gonna freeze my ass off, but I'll catch y'all when we done. All right, you guys, as you can tell, the car is finished. I'm not gonna dry it off because it's Michigan. It'll be a waste of time and effort, because literally I'm on my way home, it's gonna get dirty. I'll show you guys a little before and after. Really, all I do is hit it with the pre-soak, put the soap on it, and do the tire thing, and then I literally just rinse it. Most of it's just to get the salt off so the salt doesn't cause anything. And yeah, just so it doesn't look like a walking dirt mobile. I'll give you guys another start. Real quick, just a helpful tip for you guys. If you guys do go through the car wash often, the hand or the self-wash one, I definitely recommend getting something to keep changing, so you can have stuff to always have money to get your car washed, you know, extra stuff laying around and all that. All right, you guys, we done finally made it back to the crib. Honestly, it don't look too bad to what it usually is, you know, driving home from getting a car wash. It's really not that bad. I mean, the tires, you know, of course, there's going to be snow. I didn't dry it either, like I said, because there's literally no point, you know. This is literally frozen. I can show you, look, this is a good representation if anyone watches my stuff and they're not Michigan or don't experience this weather. This is literally ice. Like, look, you see that? Ice. All you can do is sit here and sigh about it because I'm in Michigan. There's nothing I can do. But let's get into the video. What everyone clicked on this for, let's get into my mods. And we're going to start over here from the front. All right, you guys. So we're going to start from the front and move around the back. This is just my exterior mods and stuff. So I'm not going to start from first thing I did because, you know, it'd be hard to get all that in order and stuff. But it's kind of funny because this is the first thing I did was I added this little claw stripe vinyl thing, whatever you want to call it. And it did originally come up to here onto the hood. Let me get that off. Oops. But originally when I wrapped my car, I wanted to wrap the whole hood black. So I took it off because I was thinking I don't want that under the vinyl because it would look weird. But I ended up doing stripes. So onto the second mod are my stripes. As you can see, they're matte black. And actually, fun fact, I did these myself. I was going to go to a shop, but then I was like, you know, this is something I might be interested in doing later on as like a little business. So I was like, I might as well learn. And I did it. This was about my second, third attempt. The first two attempts, I only did this front part just to get used to working with vinyl, the knifeless tape, all that. Then on the third try, I did everything. Goes all the way down to that bottom bumper right there. Comes up. Goes all the way. And then goes on the roof. Coming to what is now the third mod that I did is I got my YouTube channel on my front windshield. This was done by Big Time Graphics. Shout out to them. Make sure you check them out. I got it done probably, I think it was just before winter came. It was probably sometime in fall. But yeah, onto the fourth mod, exterior mod. It's my window tint. Comment right now down below what you think my window tint is. Most people already know it because I post it on my story all the time because I love it. You know, I literally cannot drive a car if it doesn't have tint. But if you guys already commented, I'm going to tell you guys. So this 5% back window, 5% passenger door, 5%. But this front one is 15. Why I didn't go 5 on the front? Well, it's because I already got 5 everywhere else. If I'm driving at night, I like to see where I'm going, you know. I feel like if I had 5 on the front, it would be super hard to see. Driving with 15 on the front at night, it really isn't that bad. The fifth mod are my side panel stickers. I did these ones myself. This is my TGO sticker, my brand club, whatever you want to call it, that me and my friends have that we're working on. It's called the Get Off. The Get Off. So, you know, stay tuned. We're going to have merch coming real soon. Still working on everything, you know, that. So, you know, it's homemade and everything. And then I also made this, which is my Instagram, Domo Simonetti. If you guys haven't already followed that, make sure you follow that. Oh my god, I almost forgot. Okay, so these rims, originally, they were this aluminum color. I believe it's called like premium aluminum or something, the whole rims were. But then I plastic dipped them. You guys should already know that if you're loyal to my channel, because I made a whole video with a tutorial how to do it. They got a little scuffed up when I got new tires, as you can see right here, kind of. But you know, that's just what happens if you get new tires. If you have plastic dip rims, they're gonna get messed up a little bit. I don't even know the number. Onto the next mod, it's my gas cap. Did this myself. The old gas cap, I'm not gonna try to look through all this, but the old gas cap is in here somewhere. It was chrome. I didn't like the chrome. I wanted my car smoked out, blacked out, whatever you want to call it as you can see how it is now. And the chrome just really wasn't flying. So I was like, it's got to go. So I ordered this thing off Amazon, installed it myself. It wasn't really that hard to install, but I like it. On to the next mod is my louver. Once again, this is all literally ice. If I was a little baby Lego person, I could ice skate on my whole car. But I'm not going to do it because it would scratch my paint. And I'll kill that little Lego. This is my louver. I also installed this myself. Fun fact, I installed everything on this car myself, literally besides the window tint and then my exhaust. It was kind of difficult to install one person. If I would have had two people, or not two people, if it would have been two people installing, if I would have had someone to help me, it would have been way easier. But it's pretty simple. You just tack down the little plates right here onto the actual window, then you fasten the actual louver on. It also has, let me see if I can get it on camera. It's probably a little too dark under there. But it has little like sponge pads right under here. So if I'm on the highway and stuff, if it didn't have them, it would go like this and like hit the window. But since there's a little sponge pads under it, it absorbs it. So it just hits a sponge pad and doesn't make any noise. Otherwise, it would make that annoying flapping, clapping sound, or whatever you want to call it. Not the last mod, the last exterior mod. I did this myself again. Shout out to me. Pat myself on the back. My side tents. Let me come over here where there's a little more light. You can also see it on the back. Because usually on Challengers, these are white, but they're black because I smoked them out. Tail light tent. Also right here, this right here, that area is usually orange. As well as right here, this is usually orange. Where's the one up here? This also as well is usually orange, but I tinted them out, smoked them out, whatever you want to call them, and they're black now. We're going to get into the interior mods, so we're going to jump in the car for the fifth time this video. Word of advice, guys, I'm going to turn my car on, so I'm opening my garage, because if you sit in a garage with your car running, it's possible you can poison yourself and kill yourself, so just keep that in mind. So I'm going to turn this thing on. Yeah, we like that. We like that. One day this is gonna say 200 plus, you feel me? All right, you guys, so one of the first things I did was I ordered these off Amazon. I'm gonna pull one up from the little side door. Are these little kind of I call them floor mats, but they're really multiple mats for your car. I also have them in the cup holder down there. So pretty much if, like, you know, your cup holders get dirty, your little side panel areas get dirty, these things are a life changer, because instead of, you know, having to get in there, clean it out, literally just pull this out, clean it, and then put it back in. It's as simple as that. You literally just drop it right in there and it's all good. We'll start over here since you guys have seen these quite often. I have a radar. It's a Cobra 480i. I have not gotten a ticket. I've not gotten pulled over. None of that since I got it. So shout out to that. That saved me a lot of money. I also got a dash cam. In Michigan, especially in the winter, there's a lot of drivers, you know, nothing against new drivers, whatever, but there's a lot of drivers, you know, that just drive like it's summer, you know, and you can't do that in the winter because you're going to slide, you know. So I bought the, yeah, there's literally no light in here because of this tent, but I bought it because, you know, just another level of insurance, you know. If somebody hits me, they can't, you know, make a claim that it was my fault, because this thing will literally have my back. All right, you guys, the next mod is my trim lights. Did these 100% by myself, my own idea. No offense to anybody around here that has these, but, you know, I was the first one to do these things. And, you know, of course I'm going to show love when people ask what they are. I'm going to send them the link, whatever. But, you know, this is my original idea, you know. So I'm pretty proud of myself because this came out really sweet. And usually I have it on purple because that's the color of my car. But I've been having it on red because it's kind of growing on me. You know, if you have a Dodge, no offense to Dodge, but their interior design is pretty bland. It's pretty boring. So adding these things definitely added, you know, some spice or whatever TikTok be saying. Let me get you guys some better lighting real quick. Hold on. That's a little harsh lighting because it's my phone. But this is literally the only performance mod I have. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys. The last exterior mod, I literally got no lighting here. That's one thing with tinted windows. If you're trying to YouTube, you're not going to be able to, you know, get good lighting in your whip. I also got my exhaust done. Straight piped 100% besides the cats. Took my mufflers off. Took my resonators off. That's why I like... I just messed my window clean up, so that's awesome. I don't really know if people count that as a performance mod. I've heard mixed opinions on, you know, straight pipes adding more, you know, torque, whatever. I think it does. I felt a difference when I got my car back from the shop. This is my secret weapon, you know. This, you know, this ain't no regular Challenger. This ain't no regular V6. You know, this thing get up. It's thanks to this bad boy. Shout out to my boy Scary Cat. Make sure you guys go check out his Instagram and stuff. He hooked me up. I bought this off him. He threw me a deal. It's got four modes: Eco, City, Sport, Sport Plus. Eco's if you want to save gas. It also has four modes down here. Well, eight really. It goes all the way from -4 to -1, all the way to +1 to +4. You know, +4, you know, being the max, -4 being the lowest. I drive in Sport Plus +4. Because you never know who's going to, you know, be rowdy in traffic, who's going to have to get the gap sauce, you know. This ain't no Hellcat, no Scat Pack, whatever, but my thing can hold its weight, you know, against regular V8s, RTs, whatever. I beat two RTs, so, you know, it definitely ain't no joke. Right here, real quick, if you don't believe me, that it helps. Usually, this car's stock speed is 6.2, 6.3. Mine is 5.6. That's it for the mods, for real. Let me turn the lights off. I really enjoy it, you know. Everything I've done on my car is unique because everything was my own idea. Like I was saying, though, you know, my car is unique. Everything that's done to it was my idea. Everything done to it, I've put my own time, my own money, sweat, blood, installing it, besides the tint and the exhaust. But yeah, honestly, I love it, man. And bro, there's so much more I could do to make it so much cold, so hard, whatever people call it these days. But I'm just gonna wait till the next car, because, you know, it just puts a smile on my face. I can't say too much. It's getting hot in here. My cheeks are starting to get red. But that's the video. That's the mods done to my car. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm going to be trying to bring a video every week. You know, better quality, progressing every week. You know, more, you know, shots, B-rolls, cinematography, whatever you want to call it, man. We back at it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys got any questions, how to put something I have in my car on your car, where I got it, whatever, just hit me up on Instagram. I check all my DMs. And yeah, that's it. Hope you guys have a good day. Yeah, make sure you like, comment what you think, what you want to see in future videos, and subscribe and turn that bell on if you're new. Peace out.